Of all the things that could go wrong with your car, a boot that won't open might seem like a small one.
But for the couple in our next story, the problem has become much larger than they ever imagined. Caitlin has the story.
If Darryl and Caroline didn't take corners carefully before, they do now.
Did you make sure you put the eggs on the ground?
No, I'm more worried about the milk.
Up until now, their 8-year-old Hyundai hatchback has been as good as new.
It's nifty and lights on petrol. It's a nice little car.
They bought it for 12 grand from a retired couple back in 2020. But just 23,000 Ks into the Accent Elite's short life, it clamped up.
Boot won't open for some reason.
All four doors still open freely, but the boot will not budge.
So what happened?
Nothing, pretty much nothing. So it started out with the boot not opening, push the button a couple of times and it would open and close intermittently, and then it just stopped completely.
It's been that way for a year. And that time, the back seats have taken a beating.
Especially I'm an early childhood teacher, I'm like a bag lady.
But she's nervous about more than what's moving about.
I'm always wary about the car getting broken into because, you know, you always think, leave stuff on the back.
There's no lever here at the front, so the only option is the emergency release at the very back. You can imagine how fun that is to reach. The couple took it into a Hyundai dealership here in Tamaki Makaurau, Auckland.
They initially thought it was the button for the boot, so they said bring it in and they'll hook it all up and then they'll give us a complete diagnosis.
What was supposed to take a few hours took 3 days. Finding a suspected fault with the body control module, BCM for short.
It tells the boot to open when you send the signal to the main computer, and there's a few other things it obviously controls.
The diagnostics alone cost the couple $530, but although the dealer found the problem, it didn't have a solution. It had checked with Hyundai and there were no replacement parts.
The only route they suggested is we go down the second-hand market. So they said if we could track one down, then either anybody could fit it or we could bring it back to them.
Do you know what you're looking for?
No, absolutely no idea. I've never done one. So they basically said it was a module. They gave us a part number and I started to Google.
The dealer had told Darryl he'd need to find an exact match.
Some companies that had sort of had modules or they repair modules, but they said they hadn't heard of that number.
After weeks of fruitless searching, Darryl went directly to Hyundai New Zealand.
It's their vehicle, it's their parts, they should know everything on it.
But the response was the same.
We don't make it, we don't stock it, we don't keep it, there's nothing else we can do.
Under the CGA, manufacturers must take reasonable action to ensure parts are available for a reasonable period of time. So what does that mean for a car?
Vehicles are an interesting case because with most products, it's quite ambiguous how long a reasonable period of time is. But with a vehicle, we've got a lot of data about the age of the cars in our passenger fleet.
Paul Smith from Consumer is talking about data held by the Ministry of Transport, which tells us the average age of a car on our roads is nearly 15 years old.
I think it's quite reasonable that if you're a manufacturer selling a car in New Zealand, you should support the car for at least the average period.
Because it's the manufacturer's responsibility to supply parts, you can go straight to them rather than through the retailer you bought the car from. In Darryl and Caroline's case, they bought their Hyundai from another couple in a private sale, so they're not protected by the Consumer Guarantees Act. But Paul says that shouldn't matter. It all comes back to what is reasonable.
If you've bought a car that may be 5 or 6 years old, and you've bought it privately, you'd still expect the manufacturer to cover that, even if it's not absolutely laid out in your Consumer Rights Act.
And not to be left with a dud.
I know it's a boot, but it's a big part of the vehicle. No one's going to buy it if half the thing doesn't work.
A little help would go a long way.
Even if they had just said, listen, we don't sell it, but we can get you a technical person on the phone or an email address of someone that can try help you solve it.
Instead, they've had to get creative.
So you've figured out some sort of workaround?
So we've managed to figure out if we can get a little bit of rope from the back seat to the emergency quick release if you give it a tug and I lift at the same time, we need two people.
Two people?
Yeah, okay. We should be able to open it. You don't have to pull it too hard.
All right. One, two, three.
And that's nice. Us.
Hopefully Fair Go can pull on some bigger strings. We got in touch with the team at Hyundai New Zealand and laid out the issue. Hyundai wouldn't be interviewed and didn't answer any of our specific questions, but they were on the phone to Darryl in a flash.
When they contacted us, they acknowledged that they should have moved the problem up the ladder a little bit more, even though their systems said they don't have parts. The vehicle was only sort of 7 or 8 years old.
Hyundai explained BCM modules are made by a third-party manufacturer and they'd stopped making them because there was next to no demand. But they ordered a new one in for Darryl and Caroline and covered the original $500 bill from the dealership.
They refunded every bit of money that we had spent up to then and they installed the part at their cost.
We had to see it for ourselves.
Look at that.
I just want to say thank you to Fair Go because we wouldn't have got this done as quickly as we did.
Maybe one more time, just to be sure.
You know, you might think it's quite small, but that would be so frustrating. So nice work, Katie, getting it sorted.